Virophysics is the application of the knowledge of physics and the method of physics to understanding virology. With these models, we can identify where the virus might be more vulnerable and suggest an area for drug targets. What part of the virus replication cycle would you most want to target so that the drug is most likely to work very effectively? Computer simulation are there to really fill in holes that cannot be filled otherwise for a variety of reasons, one of which is ethics, right? You can't infect people with certain viruses. You can't test new drug compounds. So far, we've worked on influenza. We've worked on hepatitis C, and then we've worked on respiratory syncytial virus, RSV. So we focused exclusively on cell-to-cell transmission rather than person-to-person. Our models have gotten good enough now that we can take experimental data, fit it with the model, and extract new knowledge about the system, like the rate of virus production, how long did the cell live for. You could apply that to figure out what's going on with one strain compared to another strain. So let's say we have a brand new flu strain this year. I can put it in the system, we can do the full analysis of the data, and we can say, ah, this year influenza is going to be a little more severe because it produces a little more virus, it kills the cells a little more rapidly, and it's a little more resistant to this particular antiviral drug. If you give me a brand new compound, I can say, well, it seems to me like this drug is mostly acting to block viral release. And it seems like this is the quantity you'd have to put in to make sure resistance doesn't emerge and to have the desired effect. And that's the interest of our work for the pharmaceutical sector. In all cases where I've worked with pharmaceutical companies, it is they that have come to me with a request for a specific problem they wanted us to work on. That's been happening with Roche Pharmaceutical. They came to us at a conference. They had seen what we were presenting, had read our earlier papers on influenza and said, look, we really would like to have some modeling around avian influenza. With our drug compound. I mean, the thing about Ryerson is that you're right in the middle of it. So it's a really awesome central place to be. And Ryerson is a very kind of new emerging university in terms of still trying to define what it is and where it's going from here. And so it's an opportunity for faculty members and students to be part of that in shaping that university moving forward.